I've learned the White House is considering ways to incentivize U.S. households to purchase stocks as part of its forthcoming tax package, according to four senior administration officials familiar with these discussions. One of these proposals would see a portion of household income treated as tax-free if it were invested in stocks, according to these officials. Under one scenario, a hypothetical scenario, a household earning up to $200,000 could invest $10,000 tax-free in the market. That's beyond contributions to traditional 401ks. American households owning stock fell by 10 percentage points after the recession. Despite the rise during President Trump's tenure so far, only 55% of households are currently invested, according to Gallup. This proposal would be part of a package of tax cuts expected to be introduced this fall before the election as a sort of economic shot in the arm, which the White House is now calling Tax Reform 2.0. One official described the package as conceptual. Another described it as idealistic because it would need congressional approval to become law. But it's clear the White House wants to build an arsenal of tools to keep economic growth humming, especially ahead of voters' decisions in November. Tyler and Kelly?
Kayla, when you say tax-free, do you mean that basically the capital gains tax would be zero?
Well, all of that is to be worked out, Kelly. A lot of these proposals are big picture. They are hypothetical. They're essentially throwing ideas against the wall to see what could increase stock ownership, what could increase take-home income, investment income for people. Unclear exactly what this would do to the capital gains portion if that money or when that money is eventually realized. But certainly interesting that even despite all of the gains in the stock market up until this point, that the White House believes that Americans should have an opportunity to get in at this point.
That's an interesting, it's an interesting concept. I mean, whether it would affect gains on the stock that would not be taxable, dividends that the stocks or funds might pay that would not be taxable, or whether you would somehow get a tax credit or a tax deduction for the amount you invest, right? I mean, that's the way basically a 401k works, is it turns taxable income into it's a salary reduction plan, basically.
Right, but Tyler, to access a 401k or a TSP, which is the government version of the 401k, you have to have a full-time employer, either a company or the federal government. So this would potentially be a way for gig workers, for 1099 workers, for part-time workers to be able to access some of that tax-free gain in the stock market. But of course, the obvious downside is, what if all these Americans get in and then the stock market falls? Certainly, that would be a major risk if this were to happen.
One thought on this, Robert, is that it's one thing to set up a structure that would be meant to encourage savings and to say we want more stock participation, but for a long term, you know, to realize those benefits over time. It's another thing if you just say, you know, hey, you can start, put money in the stock market today, take it out this year, take it out whenever you want.
Right.
And again, not only with the market already at all-time highs, but potentially making creating a lot more enthusiasm out there about getting in.
Yeah, to your question, it's unclear what would not be taxed. You don't pay a tax when you buy a stock, right? So it's unclear whether it's capital gains. What this is an election tool. So this is to draw a sharp contrast between every other candidate on the Democratic side, that including Joe Biden and Michael Bloomberg, that wants to tax capital gains, i.e. what you invest in stock, the same as ordinary income, which would effectively, in Bloomberg's case, double what you pay in a capital gain when you sell a stock. So even though they're saying this is for the middle class, this is basically them being able to tell voters out there they want to raise taxes on everything, including when you buy stock and save. We're going to do the opposite.
Sure. Do you think it's broadly appealing? Because to your point, the capital gains tax tends to animate, you know, a lot of higher income people, you know, those who have various different investments where it means a big hit. But this plan is meant, I think, to be broadly appealing. And I wonder if it will be so.
If they're saying we're going to wipe out capital gains taxes for anyone that makes less than $200,000 on stocks, yeah, that's appealing. What about the revenue you're going to lose on that? And how do you measure it? And then how do you declare sort of maybe a separate entity that can then buy stocks? It's a very complicated issue, but I think this is a campaign tool drawn to draw a contrast.
Well, guys, if I could just draw one more distinction here.
Go ahead.
One more distinction is the way that officials are talking about this is that income, so the money that you are making as your take-home pay would be exempt from federal tax or state and local tax if you are putting that money into the market. So where you would see the tax-free basis would be when you are earning this money if it goes into the market, not on the point, not on the point where you are selling it, although that could be one potential lever that they decide to pull or tweak. But the way they're discussing it now is this money would be free of income tax if
you end up
putting it into the market.
That's what I was maybe clumsily driving at there a moment ago, where I said that you could do it one of two ways. Either you
either you
waive the tax on the back end when you sell, or you give somebody a credit or a deduction up front, whether it's earned W-2 income or 1099 income or gig type income. And you just clarified that. I also see down there that it this is a plan that is curiously not going to be released until, quote, the fall. I wonder why.
Well, Larry Kudlow has said that it would come out in September. That's the finest point that we have seen put on this. Vice President Mike Pence has said you'll see that by the end of the year. And these officials that I talked to said it would be at some point early fall. But you do need Congress to pass this. And so there is an injection of realism by the sources that I speak to that this won't go anywhere until 2021. But it's essentially a promise to voters if you reelect this administration. This is something that's waiting in the wings for you. And then there's this question of the payroll tax cut, which was something that was floated in quarters prior to right now. And I'm told that this is a tool that's in the toolkit only if the economy declines significantly, whether growth goes, you know, essentially the economy takes a nosedive. If we go into a recession, or it looks like the economy is going into a recession, then and only then is when the White House would consider a payroll tax cut.
It's fascinating. This would actually be a way of avoiding income tax by putting that money into the market. That would be broadly appealing,
it's
Robert.
It's a federal subsidy of the stock market.
Yes, exactly.